So what I'm going to show how to make is something that looks like this. It's kind of almost like a fashion Instagram filter using some kind of lights and kind of flashy kind of look. And so we're going to be using a program called Spark AR for this. You can download it from the Facebook site, sparkar.facebook.com. It's free. You can use it to make any kind of Facebook or Instagram filter. So what we're going to talk about is how to make this from scratch and kind of the steps to do this. So the first thing I'm going to do is actually just close down this demo one, and I'm going to make a brand new one from scratch. So the reason I'm doing it from scratch is, again, I'm going to make it quite custom. It's not too tricky to make this stuff, but it'll talk through it. So again, I'm just going to make this a little bit bigger just to show all the features of Spark AR. So the first thing we have is our guy in the corner. I'm going to call him Ted just because I want to give him a name. And we can see Ted is moving his head around. At the moment, it's just showing exactly what is on camera. Now we can see in this sidebar here over on the left, we have a device and camera with some things in here like the microphone. Most of this stuff is not things that we're going to really work with. There's other things that we can start to add into our camera that I built as part of Spark AR. So what I can do is actually change the video as well. So if I want to try with different people, I can show off different people. It's always good to try on different skin tones and different types of people in general. There we go, you can go through. And one thing you can do is you can set it up to actually go on webcams, and here we go. So here's me kind of trying it out from scratch. And again, it's just showing off my camera at the moment. So for now, I'm just going to switch back to Ted just because we've got a bit more of a test subject that we can use. So for now, I'm going to switch back. So what do we want to do here? Well, what I want to do is add almost like a mask on top of his face. So how do I go about starting to do that? Well, the first thing that I can do is actually right click this panel and click add. Now in here, there's a few things that we can add in. Now the first thing that we want to add in is a face tracker, because we want to track the face. And that kind of makes sense. And we can see here that we've now got this kind of axes come out. What we can also do within this face tracker is add in a mesh. Now, a mesh is basically kind of like a mask that goes on top of the face. But as you can see here, this is moving up and down as he changes his head around. Again, if I just right click on face tracker now, I can do add and I can do a face mesh. And what we have here is basically a mesh that is tracked to his face. And as you can see, as he moves around, it looks like that. Now, at the moment, this is using a default material. It's using this kind of check pattern that we have here. So how do we go about making something that isn't looks like this? Well, what we can do is when we select face mesh, let's call this one maybe something like fashion mask. We can kind of rename this to make sure we're talking about the right thing. So on fashion mask, what do we want this to look like? Now, if you've done any kind of like HTML and CSS, HTML is the kind of like content, CSS is a style. Here we've got our content, we need some style on this. So here what I'm gonna do is add a material. I'm gonna click a materials and click the plus icon. And as you can see here, it's given us a default material called material zero. Now, if I double click this, I can open it up to kind of see all the properties of this. Now I'm just gonna rename this to fashion material, just to know which one is which. Fashion material zero doesn't really make any sense. But as we can see here, we have different kind of things that we can change. We can change the color of this mask pretty easily to be whatever color we want to be. We can actually change a lot of this stuff in general, the tiling options, and there's a lot of things we can actually do this. We can also add textures in here as well. So if we want to put an image on top of this mask, we can put it in pretty easily. But what do we actually want to do here? If I look at the shader type, I've actually got a few different options of what I can add. I can add in a flat mask, which looks like this. Basically, it's not ignoring any of the lighting system. I can change this color and it's flat, of course. What I can also do is change it to something like physically based, which kind of adds a bit more metallic and roughness to it as well. There's other things in here like face paint. So this is on top of his current face, of course. At the moment, it's the white area we're changing on top. So there's a few things that we can add in these shader types. There's also things like retouching. So we can add in things like skin smoothing. It's kind of smooth his skin, kind of a nice fashion-y kind of beauty effects, I suppose. What we want to add in is actually a kind of shiny effect on the final one. So we're going to use a physically based material. As you can see here, it's kind of removed his eyes from this. When we change it to the skin smoothing, it does that by default. So how do we get the eyes back? Well, again, this isn't how it looks, it's how it acts. If I go to fashion mask, it's already turned off eyes. There is eyes. And his mouth comes back. So we're just adding some holes in this mask. So again, I kind of want to change how this looks. So I'm going to go into my materials. So here what I'm going to do is actually increase the metallic surface. And as we can see, as we start to increase this up, this changes the color of the mask. It's making it more reflective. Now, other things I can start to add into this are things like environment. So if I click environment, it's currently not turned on. If I turn on environment, what I can also add in is a texture. Now, I don't have an environment texture at the moment, but what I can do is add one to my project. If I go to add environment texture, I've got some presets. So in here, I've got a few that I can add in, maybe a sunrise one. We can see the sunrise effect in here, and I've added this to my project. But what I can do now is add the environment to this sunrise, and we can see here it's given us almost like a metallic kind of effect. It's almost reflecting this general environment because it doesn't know about the context around this. The camera is only seeing what is currently on screen. Now, we're not going to be using the environment in the long term, so we will be turning it off a little bit later. But for now, we can see kind of what's going on. Now, what I'm going to do is actually just increase the roughness here. We can kind of see that this roughness of the material kind of increases to almost like a flat metal, an almost unreflective metal as we kind of move this up and down. Now, I'm going to put mine to about 30-ish for now. So it's not too reflective in terms of the surface around it, but it is very metallic. We can see here if I turn the metallic down or up, it reflects the surface around it. So I'm going to do 130 here. I can also change the render options as well to say, at the moment, this is giving me an alpha channel, which is saying, make the mask exactly as it looks. What I'm actually going to change this to is an addition blend. So what this is going to do is add it on top of the face, which is kind of what we want to do with our fashion mask. So if I click add, what we'll see is this kind of adds on top of the skin, and it kind of looks a little bit see-through if we kind of zoom in on this bit, kind of a little bit see-through. Now, what I'm also going to do is remove this environment because I don't really want to reflect the sunrise around this. I just want to reflect the general scene. So if I just remove this for now, we kind of get this shiny mask on top of this. I can start to change the opacity to kind of make this fit, but what we have is this kind of reflection of the two lights that are part of the scene. So the two lights that are part of the scene are the ambient light, which is currently not that strong. If I kind of increase it up and down, it doesn't really make too much of a difference. But the directional light is actually just above this. And we can see here it's kind of reflecting downwards and straight forwards. But if I just start to reduce this up and down, we can kind of see the light turn up and down. Now I'm going to make this intensity something around 30-ish% as well, so it's not too strong. But what I'm going to do is also add two different lights. So I'm going to add in another here, which is going to be another directional light. Now I'm going to move this over. So I'm just going to kind of make these together. I'm going to move its position. Now if I increase this panel, we can see this is in a different place. So I'm going to move this in the X direction by maybe a little bit, maybe 0.1. And that's kind of moved it over here. We can kind of see the scene going over. Maybe I'm going to change this color to something like pink. We can kind of see the pink light coming in. I'm going to turn the intensity down a little bit. So maybe 30 as well. Maybe I'm going to increase this a little bit more, maybe minus 0.2, a little bit further away. I'm going to keep that Y position, keep that X position as well. But I'm also going to rotate it so this light isn't just facing away from this. I'm going to turn it towards him a little bit. So this is going to turn this in which direction? I have my X, Y, and Z direction. I want to move it in this angle. So I'm going to twist it around the Y direction. So I'm going to move it by 45 degrees. Maybe it's minus 45 degrees facing the other way. So this is facing towards him now. I'm also going to do this with the green light as well. So I'm going to do the same thing again. I'm going to add another ambient light. And this is currently up here. It's in the wrong position. And this is because I've nested it inside this light. So I just want to kind of redo this based on the whole focal distance. And here, what I want to do is something, let's just reset it for now. Maybe this is 0.2. And then this one is, what is this other light going to be? This is 0.25. So maybe this 0.25 as well, and this is 0.3, and the rotation's all messed up, so I'm going to make this one 0, 0, 0 for now, just to reset it. And where is this first one? So one over here. This is minus 45, minus 45. So I want this one to be on the other side, which it is, but facing in a different way. So I'm going to make this one minus 45 pointing down and plus 45 to turn back the other way. I'm also going to make this light green just so we can see that in there as well. And maybe just turn the intensity down a little bit more, maybe 30% as well. So what I have now is basically this shiny mask that kind of starts to appear, and I can kind of play around with this a little bit more. Maybe what I want to do is increase this a bit wider, and maybe on light number one, I'm going to increase this one a little bit wider as well. So what I have now is basically a shiny metallic mask that's added on top of the face in this blend mode. But you might notice here there's this kind of area around this edge, which we don't really want to appear. So how do I get rid of this edge? Well, what I'm going to do is add another mask on top of this mask that only shows the middle of the face, the middle of this mask. So basically what I want to do is blend in this edge around his face. So I'm going to add into our face tracker, I'm going to add another face mesh. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new material for this. So the material that I'm going to add for this one is going to be, maybe let's call it something like cutout. As you can see here, this is having the standard mask on here. It's not shiny, but it's kind of the standard lit mask. So it's got all the lights on this at the moment. But what I can do is actually change this to a flat mask. Again, this is now white. But what I want to do is show my face, or show his face, on this mask. How do I do that? Well, what I can do as part of the face tracker is I can extract the face behind the mask. So if I go into face tracker 0, I can click texture extraction. And what it's gonna do is gonna make a face tracker 0 texture. Now, what does that even mean? Well, if I click here, it doesn't show anything. So I'm kind of at a loss at the moment, but this is dependent on the face tracker and what is underneath that face tracker. So almost if I remove these two meshes at the moment. Now, again, I'm just gonna rename this one, cut out mask, just so I can see the difference between the two. And on this material, what I can now change this to, this texture, is gonna be this new texture called face tracker. So I've basically got my face, as you can see in this middle bit, over my face, which means if I click on cutout mask, I can do a lot of things kind of weird with this. I can increase the scale, for instance, make my face a little bit bigger on my face, which kind of looks a little bit strange. Now, of course, what I don't want to do is I kind of want to keep it normal. So I'm just going to make this 1, 1, 1 again. And what I actually want to do is I want to cut out this middle bit of my mask. So I show through, if I just kind of hide this one, the mask underneath. How do I go about that? Well, what I need to do is add a texture, an alpha texture, to this cutout mask to just show these edges. I kind of want to show the middle bit of this face. How do I make that texture? Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly jump into a different program. I'm going to jump into Figma. Now, Figma is just a kind of graphics editor. I'm just going to quickly create a new artboard. So in here, I'm just going to create a square. This one is going to be, maybe I'm going to make it 1,000 by 1,000. I'm just going to make the background for now something like dark red. Now, what I want to do is basically have something that cuts a hole in the middle of this whole mask. So I'm basically going to make a rectangle that covers this whole area, 1,000 by 1,000. And what I'm going to do is add a new radial gradient. Now, what I want to do is basically have the edges being dark and the middle bit being empty. So at the moment, this is kind of going to go to white color and a white color around the edge. I can start to play around with this. Maybe I just want to show the very nose area, or maybe the eyes area, for instance. Maybe I want to increase this a little bit so it shows more in the middle. So there's a few things I can actually do with this. So I'm going to change that to make it a little bit wider in the middle. So I've got this kind of see-through area. Pretend there's a face in the middle of this, and I want this white area to cut out. So I'm going to basically save this whole thing by exporting this. I don't want to show this red area, so I'm going to get rid of that. And I'm going to export this to my home called the cutout-texture. Now, what I'm going to do is add that cutout texture to this page, or to this project. How do I do that? Well, again, I'm just going to go into my Finder, going to go to Desktop and add this to my project. You can see here we have a white area that's cut out in the middle. So now what I want to do is on my cutout mask, I want to go into my material because it's how it looks. I'm going to double click and I can add in an alpha channel to this. So if I open this up, I'm going to click check and I'm going to add this texture, cutout texture, to the middle. So we can see now that this kind of middle area is the only thing that gets cut through. And I can turn this up and down. You can kind of see these edges kind of fade in and out up here if I kind of increase this. It's very subtle, but it just removes that kind of edge area. Maybe I want to do a little bit further in, so I'd go back into my Figma file. Maybe it's too close to the edges. I'm going to change my fill so it's more in the middle. There it is. And I'm going to re-export that. Again, cutout texture. And instead of just dragging this in again, what I'm going to do is actually right-click this and replace, because I don't want to just keep adding more and more textures into this, just one at a time. And then I'm going to add this in. And you can see now that this kind of edge doesn't go right to the end. It kind of feels a bit more natural now. And again, if I kind of start to change this and see how it looks, and if I kind of have that area, you can see that on his forehead, for instance, this line disappears where the edges are. Why do you want to test this out? So again, I can go to my video up here in the corner. I can test with different people, see how that looks. Looks pretty good. Looks pretty good there. And I can also test with my webcam. There I am. Again, if you do go to webcam, you might notice that sometimes it does mess up a little bit. What you can actually do is just press restart and it should fix it a little bit. There we go. There is some edges to this. Again, it's not perfect because my microphone is kind of in the way at the moment. So I'm just going to ignore that for now. You can see it in the background there. But what I have is some kind of fashion filter that's done pretty quickly. Now, how do I test this on a phone so that other people can do this? Well, there is an app that you can use called Spark AR. And basically, you can download it for iOS and Android. And what you need to do is almost like plug your phone in. There it is. And what I'm going to do is I can click this test on device. And I can click send to Rick's iPhone. And now what I'll get on my phone is something that looks like that. So there we go. We can test it pretty easily. Looks pretty good, pretty quickly. And once I'm done with this, what I can do is click upload. And then once I've done, I can go into Facebook and actually upload this from scratch and basically deploy this. Once I've tested it, once I've made sure that everything looks good, I've made something pretty quick that looks pretty decent in a very short amount of time.